The director, Dr. Christopher Wild of IARC right now, stated that the pressure that IARC has received in response to listing glyphosate as a probable human carcinogen, group 2A, has resulted in unprecedented coordinated efforts to undermine the evaluation, the program, and the organization. These efforts are largely sponsored and coordinated by the agrochemical industry that sought to support its own regulation, its registration and approval of glyphosate in the US and around the world, to defend itself in litigation against farmers that were once Monsanto customers and are now cancer patients, and to prevent the labeling of glyphosate-containing products as a carcinogen in the state of California, which would inform the public. My guess is that there's not many people in the U.S. that are unexposed to glyphosate because of how widespread its use is. It's almost 300 million pounds annually and in agriculture, and every one of those pounds are put out onto our fields, our food supplies, get into our rivers and streams and drinking water, sources of drinking water. And in conclusion, I would like to say that fundamentally, this hearing is about the ability of a public health agency to call a carcinogen, even if that carcinogen makes a huge amount of money for powerful corporations.